Okay, so somebody was requesting a video for me to show how I made my buck saw that I did on the TV show that I was on, America Unplugged, episode 4. On that TV show, I made a backcountry or woodsman's buck saw using sticks and stuff. And so I'm out here today to find some good quality sticks that I can use to cut down to make another one for y'all. I will be using the exact same saw blade on this saw that I used in that TV show. I'm just gonna make some new handles and stuff for it. And I'm also using the same pocket saw to make the handles that I used in that TV show. Let's see here. This looks like it may be good enough. I'm not gonna really know until I cut into it. But hopefully it'll be good enough. Let's find a good surface here where I can cut safely. You don't want green wood, but you don't want rotten wood. Good piece of good hardwood with a good center core like that's gonna be nice. I'm gonna set this here, hoping to get both of my pieces out of this. I don't know, it's got a bit of a curve to it. It's by no means going to be the same quality as the TV show people did, as far as video quality. So, I have to deal with that. Alrighty. That piece looks like I might be able to get a good chunk out of it. Let's see here. Got the camera, GoPro camera mounted to the GoPro chesty, obviously, on my chest. There's a couple pieces there, and need a couple more pieces. Let's see. These limbs come off the tree that my wife and I cut down in that TV show last year. So, let's see here. Check the diameter. It's close. Let's get this piece here. Let's go. Oh, I didn't see that. Got the big old knots in the woodpecker hole, so that's not gonna actually be any good. This piece here should do it though. So this saw is for small stuff like what we're cutting right now, but the saw I'm gonna make is for bigger stuff, like actually taking down trees and whatnot. These ought to do it. So, I'm gonna turn the camera off here, go back to my workspace, and show you the rest of it. Okay, so before we actually begin, I want to let y'all know that it is very easy to cut your finger off doing this kind of stuff. So make sure you take heed to that if you try this at home. Here are the parts. It involves three sticks. This one's going to be cut down. Well, they're all going to be cut down a little bit. This one here is going to be about the size that we're going to leave it at. This one's going to be cut down to match it. So we're going to cut it right about here to match the same size as this one. We're just going to leave the bark on. And then this one here is going to be cut because we're going to make a H frame like this. So once we have these, the two end pieces prepared, we'll take our saw blade, stick it in here, and let me see if you can see that on camera. Yeah, we'll have our saw blade in place, and then we'll determine how long this one's got to be, and we'll cut that one. So this will be the last piece we cut here. So we're going to set that off to the side. This here is my forestry saw blade. That's the actual name of the blade. I took the cardboard sheath that it comes in, and I just put some camouflage duct tape on it to make it last longer so that I would have a sheath for a saw blade. The actual name of this tooth pattern and everything is the forestry blade, and it's designed to be able to cut through all the different types of wood, hard, soft, green, or dead, that you find in the forestry. So it's not perfect for any specific one, but it's great. It's a great saw blade, general purpose saw blade. You know, if you wanted to cut specifically hardwood, then you would get a different tooth blade. If you want to specifically cut softwood, you get a different tooth blade, tooth pattern. If you wanted to cut greenwood, you get a different tooth pattern, or deadwood. But if you want something that cuts all of them at reasonably well, and so you don't have to shuffle between all your different blades, then this one blade here will cut all of them generally well enough. And it's the best blade, I suggest. Here's a closer look at the tooth pattern. And it's called the forestry blade. They're hard to find. And in fact, this is the only one I've been able to find for a couple of years now. And the pins I use are the pins that you pull out of the backpack, external frame backpack, backpack frames that hold the backpack to the frame. And they happen to fit into the holes in the ends of the saw blade perfectly. And you'll see how that's used later. And this is a 24-inch blade, which is great for taking down trees and building shelters and stuff with. This is just a regular 6-inch blade, which is good for making campfires and doing little projects with. So if I was going to go out and live in the forest, or live in the woods, or do some extreme bushcrafting, these are the two blades I would take. So I use my small blade to make my tools with, including the buck saw, and then I use the big blade for making my shelters and stuff, and my home and stuff like that with. So let's get started here. Put these together. I'm gonna make my mark. There we go. And move that out of the way. And my wife just pulled up, so I'm gonna turn the camera off, and then as soon as the dogs settle down, I'll turn it back on and I'll pick up where I left off. Okay, so let's finish this up. Got my mark. They're about even. So now what you want is, you see these two, hopefully you can see it, they do have a slight curve in it, so let's try to keep those curves to the outside. Roll this one over. So if your sticks are curved, haven't curved to the outside, It's always better to have perfectly straight sticks, but you can't really get that. And keeping the curve in mind, you want to make sure that when you're going to have to cut a slit going in this way. So keep your curves in mind if you have a curve in the stick, that the curve curves away from, this is the center, the curve of your stick is going to curve away outwards away from the center, and your slot's going to have to go with that. So let's get that in there. This is the part where you can cut your hand, so you got to be careful. It's best if you have some leather gloves on. I don't have any with me right now, so I'm going to be very, very careful. Make soft, careful strokes. You want to get a line going, and then you set it down on the table. There we go. Alright, now I got my line going. Set it down on the table. Ralph, go. You don't want to use your knife and just split the stick. You have to saw the end. You cannot use your knife to just split the stick. And you'll see why shortly. If you use your knife to split the end of the stick, then you fracture the stick and you get a fracture line that runs all the way up it, and it defeats the purpose of what you're trying to do here. Alright, I go in the width of my saw blade here, so that this, because the width of this saw blade is much larger or much wider than the width of the blade that I'm going to put in it. So when I put this blade in it, which is actually going to go this way, but I'm just testing it right now, so I want the teeth away from my thumb. It's going to go in like that, and there's no exposed blade right there, which is important. So as you can see, it goes, that's what that pin's going to do and hold it in place. This pin is one of the key factors as to why this saw works so well. If you could just use a stick in there, but then it's going to be very weak. It's only going to be, this saw is only as strong as this pin is. So the stronger this pin, the stronger your saw is, and the way you hold it when you use it. So there's that one. Now to get the other one set. There's the curve. I don't know if you can hear my wind turbine or not, but it's spinning like mad. There we go. If you're going to cut yourself, this is most likely the time that you're going to do it. Okay. Almost done. There we go. Whew. I hate cutting those ends because they're very hard. Pull the piece out. Double check it. It's actually had to saw through one side and not, so my cut didn't get very straight, but it'll still work. So there you go. Should be in deep enough. Check that screen there. All right. So, okay. Now, time to pull these pins off. There you go. You leave this one on. You want to pull the saw blade all the way out. Put the pin in. There you go. All right, so you got your pins in. Now, again, this is just for measurement's sake, so I'm putting the teeth in backwards. There's one in. There's the other. All right. So you see what I got in here? I got the pins in and got them centered. Same thing with this side here. So they're all the way down in, good to go. Now what we want to do is have these sticks here kind of straight, just kind of eyeball it. You can take this stick here and set it on there. Now you want to cut this stick a little bit shorter than the outside measurement. So you got the outside measurement here, which is from here to here. And the idea here is that you want these sticks to pull inwards like this. So as the top of the sticks pull inwards like this, it puts tension on this blade, making it nice and tight. So you're going to cut this stick here to act as like a rocker. And so you start out by cutting it the full length. And then you're going to cut, well, you're going to cut it almost the full length, I should say, because you want to cut it to, I'm going to cut it to the halfway point here on this stick and the halfway point on this stick over here. So almost the full length, I guess. And so right about there. Should do it. All right. All right, set that off to the side. Okay, so this one has a curve in it too. So with the curve, you want to make sure that you got the curve either facing upwards or downwards. And then you're going to put your notches in. So get your knife out and done with my saw blade for now. So I'm gonna close that up. So I got the curve, the curvature is facing towards me. I'm gonna carve my notch. Or, sorry, my wedge. Starting to punch through the table. Okay, so there's your wedge. You don't want it too thin or anything or it'll break off. Clean it up just a little bit. All right, so now we're gonna do the same thing the other side. This end has to be, the wedge has to be on the exact same side or plane or whatever you want to call it as this one, or your whole saw will get twisted. Switch hands here. Pretty hard wood. See if we get some shavings off the other side. Okay, a little sharper than I want, but the angle's a little steep, so I'm gonna see if I can't get some more off the top here. There we go. That should work. Okay. Put my knife away. Now, settle down, guys. Bring the saw back over here. And let's see. Now, what's important here is, how big of a tree do you want to, are you going to be cutting down? For the size sticks that I have, the tree, the space that I can cut, this is a 6-inch saw, the tree space that I can cut is about 6 inches, 6.5 inches diameter before I start hitting this. So I could probably do very easily do a 6-inch round tree. Because if you can't fit the diameter of the tree in between this, the bar, the rocker bar and the saw blade, then you're not going to be able to cut all the way through it. You can cut with a stick with 6 inches of space here. You can cut halfway through and then roll the tree and cut the other halfway. So you can ultimately do an 18-inch tree if you did three cuts on it. It's not going to be a perfect, clean, smooth cut all the way through, but you can cut it in thirds, you know, so that you cut down this side here, roll it over, cut this side 6 inches through, and then roll over and cut this side 6 inches through, and then you'd be able to cut an 18-inch tree with it. You would never be able to cut something that big with this. The maximum you're going to cut with this saw is about 10 inches tops. So, let's see here. Now, what you want to do here is find the center, or we can increase it a little bit more than that, but you don't want to go very much more than an inch or so above center. I usually keep it within an inch of center up. So, oops. I got my mark here. I'm gonna grab my knife and just put my mark there so I know where that's gonna go. Kind of eyeball it, make sure it's on the same side over here. There we go. Alright, so what I need to do now is I can go ahead and take this saw blade off. I'm going to set that out to the side where I'm not going to get hurt. And now, I don't want to cut the notch here where I put it on top. That's just to mark it on here. This is going to be my top side. I need to come over and put it on the inside here. So, I'm going to get my saw ready. I need to cut a V-notch or a square notch. And usually, the square notch works best. But I start with a V. And then I square it off. A square notch allows it to rock back and forth on the V that you just cut here. Like, this is shaped like a V. You don't want to cut too deep, or you end up breaking this in half. Set my saw off to the side. And you just take your knife, square it up a little. Doesn't have to be perfect. Stick it in there. Make sure it can rock just a little bit. And that one's done. Come over here. Now remember, you just mated that side up with that side. So now we're going to come over here. Put my knife away. We're going to do the same thing to this side. Pull my knife back out. There we go, so now we got another notch. This one's actually, looks like it's almost perfect. Yeah, can't really get much more perfect than that. So, this is what you've got now. Alright. Okay, so now that you've got that, you got a couple more notches to do at the top here. So let's get these sticks out of the way. Stick out of the way. Now, on the outside of the curve, come over here, put the notch in there, and come over here. Basically making a notched curve all the way around the stick. Not too deep, just deep enough for your paracord or whatever cordage it is that you're going to be using. Okay, one last one. We're almost done with this. Looks like Addy found my cantaloupe. Alrighty. There we go. Now you've got the makings of your nice saw here. Okay, so now you got your rope. Just put my saw away. Need my knife out. Put this in. Notch all the way around on this one because I put it on the wrong side. Okay, here we go. Problem solved. Alrighty. Now, we want to take our rope. This end, I just did a little bowline hitch in it. And what I want to do, I can get to the other end here. Wrap it up. Bring it around over to this other one, wrap it around there. Back to this side. Cut off enough, put this extra cord back away. Okay. Now before I tie that off, gotta put our saw blade on the proper way this time. Blade out. I see that my notch here is going to make it rock a little, so I'm going to make a little adjustment. There we go. There's a lot of different ways you can tie off your rope on the end here. I tie it off just with some simple overhand hitches or whatever you want to call them, doesn't matter. Whatever knot holds, this is not to use. Now, we need one more stick. Gotta find a good one. No good ones around here. Alright, I'm gonna turn the camera off real quick and I'll be right back and we'll just grab a decent stick. Alright, I think I got a pretty decent stick here. So, what we're gonna do now. We're going to slip it in between these and we're going to wrap it. In the wrapping process, you want to make sure that it sticks out It has enough to hit that. So the wrapping it, before you get it too tight, you want to come down and make sure that you got your toggles centered. It's all the way down in, and everything is good. Okay, now let's finish wrapping it. Should use paracord for this. I've had other cordages snap. Paracord gives a little. This is not paracord, so hopefully it doesn't snap on me. Let's check it. Probably give it another twist or two. That should be good. Okay. So now, you got your saw. Now, what you need to do here is when you're using your saw, you got to hold it down here at the bottom. If you hold it at the top, if you held it at the top up here or in the middle, here at the top in the middle, or like this, one at the top and one at the bottom, or one in the middle and one at the bottom, or like this, any of these positions will cause it to fall apart and break apart and is worthless. The only proper way to hold a saw like this is one down here at the bottom of for the pull, and then one on the push. So if you're going to be using it, you're going to take it when you pull it to you, bringing it to you, you're pulling with your, in this case, my left hand, and then when I'm taking it away, you're going to push with your right hand, so with your far hand. So when the saw is going away from you, you use your far hand to push it away, and when it's coming to you, you pull with your close hand to pull it to you. Do not take your far hand to pull it to you, because your far hand pulling it to you means this one is going to pull to you, and there's nothing to block it, so you're just going to pull the arm to you. If one of these teeth or the saw blade gets jammed, you're just going to pull the leg to you. And if the same thing, if you're pushing it away, if you push with the hand that's closest to you, push it, and the saw blade gets jammed, then you're just going to push the arm away and not the blade. So you push with the far arm and pull with the close arm. And that's how you use the saw with. And then using the metal pins here instead of sticks, the saw will never break. A lot of people claim that these saws are worthless, and when you ask them why are they worthless, oh, they fall apart on you. Well, then you ask them, well, how do you use it? Show me how you use it. And when you watch them how they use it, it's not because the saw is worthless; it's because their technique is worthless. So I'm going to take you over and show you my cutting up some logs with this now, and show you how the technique is. Where the this saw is what makes this saw. So. All right, here's a pretty decent thick tree. Pretty solid. This is what I'm gonna cut through. It's about 5 inches thick. This is what we're gonna cut down. Show you the technique. So you remember, you pull with the hand that's closest to you, and you push with the hand that's furthest away. And make sure you're clear of debris. And you take your time, you don't rush it. other log down there. It's getting in the way. Cut it off pretty nicely, and pretty good solid wood. It's not rotten or anything. That's just the bark I pulled off. So, all right, so cut another one. Cut this piece here, or cut this one off here. So, let's see. Got one more bigger piece. Yeah, and there's the other piece. So here's the saw after it. Nothing wrong with it at all. It'll be good. As pieces wear out, you can always cut new pieces and replace it. No problem. When you're done with your campsite, you pack up and it's time to leave. The only parts that you got to carry with you, the only weight you're carrying is your saw blade, the little sheath that you put it in, these little aluminum pins or whatever pins that you're using, and a piece of cordage that you're going to use to tighten it up with. Another thing is also, it also makes a great snare. So you could lay it down on the ground, find a clear spot over here. Let me shrink these legs. You can see what I'm going to show you much better. There we go. So, now that you're done with it as a saw, you could remove this, loosen this up, remove the saw blade, put another piece of cordage on this end, and make a snare if you wanted. Build this up, make it nice and tight, put a little figure four or a bait stick right here, right? Little bait stick on here, a little trigger stick, a little piece of bait on there, and then they snap on the bait. Ouch, that actually does hurt. You can put several strings around here. If you get bowed sticks, a lot of sticks that have curves in it, you can put three or four strings across here and then put them all at different tensions. You got five sticks here, another five on this side, all at different tensions. So you have 10 different tensions, you got 10 different sounds. And you go ding, 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 dong, dong, ding, ding, dong, 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 make an instrument out of it, a musical instrument. So you got a snare, like a spring snare, I guess you'd call it, a musical instrument. You put your saw blade on there, you got your saw. There are all kinds of things that you can use this little makeshift thing for. So there you have it. This is what I made, one of the things that I did on America Unplugged, and used to take down a tree and chop it up and stuff like that. And alrighty, thanks for watching.